sería correcto. El Toastmaster, fellow Toastmasters and guests, distinguished ladies and gentlemen. I'll be making a presentation on the topic, Building Capacities for Greatness. In the words of Leslie Brown, a 21st century American motivational speaker and former politician, beginning of quote, imagine, if you will, being on your deathbed, and surrounding your bed are the ghosts of the ideas, the dreams, the abilities, and the talents given to you by life. And you, for whatever reason, you never took on those ideas. You never pursued that dream. You never took on your abilities. You never used your voice. You never wrote that book. No one ever saw your leadership. And then they, surrounding your bed, look at you with large angry eyes and say, we came to you and only you could have given us life. But now we must die with you forever. The question is, if you die today, what ideas, what dreams, what abilities, what talents, what gifts will die with you? End of quote. If you can hear my voice today, ladies and gentlemen, it means that you still have the opportunity to unleash your uniqueness on our world and to be a blessing to us all. This greatness has its own demands. However, for you to attain a higher level of greatness in any area of your life, you have to expand your capacity in every aspect of your life. So, what is capacity? In the context of this speech, I define capacity to mean the maximum amount of anything that an entity is able to contain or receive. What this means is that expansion of your capacity is the foundational requirement for you to acquire knowledge, to build skill, and to develop competence. And then, when your expanded capacity stumbles upon all foreseen opportunities, a new level of greatness is born. Now, you might think about those moments when you hear about the wonderful achievements of people around you, and then you get this rumbling in your stomach and a feeling of dejection that can make you wonder if you as a person would amount to anything in life. In the words of Zig Ziglar, the 20th century American author and motivational speaker, I say, you don't have to be great to start. All you have to do is to start to be great. In order to expand your capacity for greatness, ladies and gentlemen, I'm presenting to you three key tips that will help you with that quest. One, improve your physical health. To enjoy higher levels of greatness in this life, you need to be physically strong and healthy. To build physical energy, you need to eat wholesome and balanced diet. You need to adopt good sleeping habits. You need to take proper vitamins and supplements. And then you need to exercise regularly. Number two, expand the powers of your soul, your mind. Achieving higher levels of greatness requires a mind that is soaked with greater knowledge and expertise. Without such an enlightened mind, one cannot go very far in this life. To develop the powers of your mind, you need to develop yourself by getting new skills. And it doesn't matter even if you're already a professor in two disciplines already, like psychiatry. It doesn't matter. You have to strive to invest in knowledge, even if it requires you having to attend night classes or sign up for courses from other successful coaches. The quicker you build up new skills and knowledge, the faster you begin to taste the sweetness of the high level of greatness. Number three, polish the quality of your self-talk. Most times, people do not get to the level of greatness they want in life because deep down in their spirit, they do not feel that they really want it. These people unconsciously believe that they do not deserve a higher level in life, and they are secretly afraid that if they get to that level in life, that they will not be able to handle it well. That might be your case. But if you want to come out of it, how do you do it? First, you have to condition yourself with self-talk by telling yourself every time that you deserve to achieve greatness in life. And then you visualize yourself getting to that goal. In conclusion, to everyone listening to the sound of my voice, I know that you are born with potential. You are born with goodness and trust. You are valiant beings, born with ideals and dreams. You have wings. You are not meant to crawl. If you want to achieve greatness, learn to use your wings and fly. After all, great men and great women are not born great. Great men and great women